So this is going to be a multi-part 100% tutorial. It's going to be multiple parts because this run is very long. I don't have time or energy to do this all in one sitting. But basically what I'm going to go over is I'm going to go over the 100% route as well as kind of the current strats that we know. Hopefully this helps you kind of learn where the trophies are and like where and how to kind of get them, how to do certain things, how to do certain skips. So let's get started. The first thing is, so we have a new save file. We're gonna want to make sure our settings are correct. So the options, first we have the game options. So the most important thing is to have predator awareness turned off. Basically, when you are in a predator and an enemy spots you, there's like a slowdown that can happen, and we want to turn that off because the cam because it slows things down. So that's the most important thing. The rest you can kind of change based on your preference. I tend to use defaults, and I like to have hints on just as like cues sometimes, maybe if my sound isn't working. For graphics, so I play everything on low settings, or kind of the lowest settings, which is kind of it's up to you. But the most important thing is so FPS. I play on 30 just because my computer doesn't handle 60 very well. There are some glitches and skips that re there are some glitches and skips that require 30 FPS, but you don't do that many of them, so it's not like any percent where you do a lot of skips that require 30 FPS. So actually I think there's a very good argument for playing on 60 FPS and then switching the FPS back down to 30 only when you're doing certain skips, which I will call out in the tutorial. But for now I'll play on 30 just because that's what I do. But 60 has a lot of benefits. You can skip cutscenes and dialogue slightly faster. I think that the correct play is to play at 60 for the vast majority of the run. Then for key if you're playing on keyboard, it's good to have some shortcuts. So I for a few things. So one is for quick fire explosive gel, definitely have that set to a key bind. This will be important. This will make certain glitches easier. And for quick fire batarang, have that set to a key bind as well. Specifically for glitches, it's also helpful for combat, but if you do it on keyboard, but that's a little less important. Otherwise, the only other things that you might want to do is, if you're on keyboard, is unbind this gadget select and unbind AR challenges. I haven't unbound gadget select. I don't hit that button anymore. But there's no reason to use the gadget select on keyboard. And then the other thing I do is I bind the missile barrage to certain mouse but to certain mouse buttons. It's a little bit easier for me. So that once you have it set up, we can kind of start the run. One other thing is that if you're on PC, we have this thing called the route tracker. So you can see it's on the left side of the screen. What the route tracker does is, so if I start it, you have this. It basically can sh shows you kind of the entire route. Now one thing people complain about are these hints. Sometimes people don't find the hints very helpful because I think when we created the hints they were kind of consolidated. I also created them when I didn't know too much about the game, where things were. So when you don't really know what these hints refer to, it can be very hard to kind of figure out where the trophies are. And the main thing is that these hints are not really for figuring out where the trophies are or where the collectibles are or where the side missions are. They're more for making sure you didn't miss anything. So I recommend doing like practice with this tracker so you kind of learn where things are. And I'll have this open so that I can kind of show you exactly where things are as it goes up. This version of the tracker has a refresh button. Your version of the tracker won't have this. It's not a big deal. Or probably won't have this. We haven't pushed this update yet. This is in a beta feature. But basically what you do is you click start, and then this will update every time you collect something. But what it does is it looks at your save file. So it basically will update whenever your save file updates. And Arkham Knight, basically, when you do something major, it updates. But if you do something major within 8 seconds of that, then it won't update. So if you collect two trophies within 8 seconds of each other, the trophy might not get reflected on this tracker. So that's one thing to keep note of. And then when you're at, like in a bunch of interiors, you don't get very many autosaves, unless you maybe switch rooms generally. So you'll see a lot of the time when you're inside like Stag's airship, this tracker won't update. So you'll have to do a bunch of collectibles without seeing whether or not you got them until you leave the room. This is a source of this can be a source of missing collectibles in the run. That's why it's also important to not necessarily rely on this tracker to it's more to rely on this tracker to see if you forgot something. And it just basically you can I personally like I double check the tracker after I collect something and leave a room, like just to see if I missed something. I have to go back into that room to re-get that collectible. But this is an incredibly useful tool for 100% runs. I highly recommend downloading it. I'll be putting this on YouTube, so I'll have a download link to this in there in the description there. Well, let's get started. We'll see kind of the tracker go as we go on. So here, this is the standard cutscene. Not much to say here. We'll just let this play. So what I like to do is, as this is zooming out, I'd like to just double check the game options, make sure I'm playing on the difficulty that I want. The fastest difficulty for this category is easy. There's no difficulty requirement. You can play this on hard if you want. I might even call out certain things on hard that if you ever decide to do a run on hard, which I've done before, but if you ever decide to, things that you want to be aware of. And so again, in this category, the timing rules are the same as every other timing category or every other category that has the main story in it, which is the timing starts when we start burning Joker. So it starts when I would say 3, 2, 1, go, and on go, that's when the timer starts. So 3, 2, 1, go. And yeah, so then this is just the regular game.
Is how it happened. This is how the Batman died.
Yeah, so skip these cutscenes, and not much to say here. There's not much to say here until the guys start turning into monsters.
So, what'll it be? Your usual?
Sure.
Okay, chicken salad with no dressing.
No, you know what? Make it waffles with a side of bacon. Don't tell my wife.
Whatever you say, officer. Oh, and if you want some more coffee, just shout.
Hey, I'm sorry to interrupt your dinner, Officer Owens. But there's a guy smoking over there in the corner booth. Wait here. I'll have a word.
All right, so here it's faster. So once when you interact with this guy, so just try to get there as quickly as possible. I like to spam space to do it. When these guys turn into monsters, someone's gonna attack you, and the fastest thing to do is to shoot him and then walk forward. You don't have to, but it is faster to do that, so we'll just do that. So shoot him, walk forward, and you've done this intro cutscene. So let's skip some dialogue here. And then there's just long cutscene leading up to the intro. Not too much to say here.
The only people left on the streets are the sort that enjoy the chaos.
Gotham's finest.
Scum. Criminals. And worse. Not enough good people left to stop them. It took just 24 hours for us to lose control of the city. Tonight, Gotham's relying on one man to save us all.
So, the next thing I'll do is talk about the movement in the game. So, basically, when you're gliding, the thing you're going to be doing a lot in this game are grapple cancels. You're going to be gliding a lot. And this is especially important before we have any grapple boost upgrades. So the way grapple cancels work is... grapple here, you press the... on keyboard, you press the middle mouse wheel to cancel it. And what the key thing is to make sure you don't hold a direction. So notice, like, sometimes I'm like holding forward, but when you cancel, if you hold forward, you don't get nearly as much speed. So you can tell kind of how much speed you're getting if you look at the sides of your cape, and you see those lines next to the side of your cape. So you see that we're going pretty fast. What this does is this kind of preserves your forward momentum. Or preserves whatever forward momentum you have. You can do this on controller as well. So I'm gonna try to see if... Oops. Yeah, and it's the same thing. Make sure you aren't holding a direction when you are gliding. So that's kind of grapple canceling. You can also cancel grapple swings. So I just showed canceling regular grapples, but you can cancel grapple swings as well. So what grapple swings are is sometimes if you're on a gargoyle or on like a perch thing, you can swing to another vantage point basically. So the good example is here. You're on this gargoyle. This is a grapple swing, and you can cancel a grapple swing by pressing left control. So I like to hold space when I when I cancel it, it just makes it easier, but you don't have to do that. But yeah, I recommend holding space when you're doing these grapple cancels. You can do this on controller. So controller, it's the same buttons where basically you grapple and you press B. And then, yeah. Yeah, and that's basically how you're gonna be gliding in this game. Oops. And yeah, if you notice your grapple boost right now, it doesn't really, it's not very effective, so we really want to be doing this, especially in the early part of the run. We will get the grapple boost upgrades later in the run, but not yet. So when we start the game, we start here. There's an objective over there. So what I like to do first is switch to explosive gel, and press the middle mouse wheel to fall, dive for 3.5 seconds. So if you notice that if you just start gliding, you don't really have speed, and the way to kind of build up the most speed is to dive for about 3 seconds. So what I do is I count. So I go 1, 2, 3, and pull. You can straighten yourself out, that's fine. Then you have the maximum speed. Then you can grapple cancel your way to Commissioner Gordon right here. So the next objective after we talk to Barbara is to fight some guys, but before we do that, there's actually a pig side mission which we're going to do. And yeah, if you noticed on the tracker just updated once we got the autosave. So it said the first objective is to visit Gordon. And it marked it with an X. But before we actually go fight the cop, help the cop, we're going to go do our first pig murder victim. So the hint, the movement is we're on this flagpole. So we oops. These flagpoles are hard to grapple onto for some reason. But yeah, so we do the same thing. We do this and then grapple here. So the pig victim is about right here. So we're gonna glide to there. The path I like to glide to. So as you start out. Start out on the flagpole. For some reason, this flagpole's hard to grapple to. But so what I do is you drop down, dive for a little bit, then grapple cancel off of this railing here. This will take you to. This will have enough speed to take you to the pig victim, which is right here. So when it says, the hint says south failure. The only reason is that it's kind of on the south part. It's kind of like. I mean, it's kind of in the middle of Bleak Island, but it's more south than the other pig victim on Bleak Island. So that was kind of the rationale behind this hint. Now, normally we could interact with this guy normally, but just by pressing space. When we get close, we talk with Alfred for a bit. But what we can do is we can actually cancel this. So normally when we interact, we have to press at least on my controller, it's A. But if we have the explosive gel selected, what we can do is we can aim, and then what we do is alternate fire. So alternate fire is this this button that we tap here, and interact. So it would, aim and alternate fire. And interact at the same time, this will help us cancel it. And then with these kinds of interactions where we want to just cancel an animation, we then press aim right after. So the inputs look like that. One thing you need to be careful about is the alternate fire and the grapple inputs are the same on controller. So you need to make sure that you are standing kind of in the spot where you don't grapple. But yeah, and so that's the input for Oops. That's the input for doing the animation cancel for that. So skip the dialogue with Alfred, and then you can see that we have these hints as well for where to scan the pig victim. So the leftmost one is the skin layer, which is the arm. The middle one is the muscle layer, which is the chest, so it's right here. And then the last one is the bone layer. So we in the run, we do the skin, muscle, bone layer. And these are just rough parts to look at. Eventually, you'll just know. You'll just remember where these are. It'll help to narrow the search.
Clear signs of bone deformation on the victim's knee. Joint line sclerosis points to juvenile arthritis, a rare and debilitating condition.
So the reason why we get this is that we get a nice upgrade point early, and what we'll then do is get the critical strikes upgrade. So if you go to the combat upgrades, you can click on these two fists here. This is the first upgrade we get. It's very, I find it very helpful to get early on, so I highly recommend getting it. So then the next thing is we're going to do this fight, but we're going to do something called takedown cancels. So takedown cancels are a little different from the other cancel that I just showed you. So for takedown cancels, the way you do a takedown is you hold the right mouse button. So what you do to do a takedown cancel on keyboard is to you quick fire your explosive gel. So I have my quick fire button bound to T. And then you hold aim and then release it. So that's doing a takedown cancel on a keyboard. On controller, it's similar, except the takedown button is actually Y. So what you do is so the takedown button isn't the same as the aim button. So what you have to do is you quick fire gel, takedown, and hold aim after. So it's quick fire gel, takedown, and hold aim. It doesn't have to be that fast. The speed that I just did that will usually work. If I recall correctly, I don't really use controller for this, but those are kind of the inputs for it. So with this fight, I do this the same as I do in any percent, which is I throw a smoke here. It just helps make it a little more consistent. But the main nice thing about having critical strikes is that, like, if the fight doesn't go well, this is how I want the fight to go usually, but if the fight doesn't go well, at least critical strikes will make fighting the rest of these guys faster. Because critical strikes on easy lets you take out guys in basically two punches, which is very nice. So we'll rescue this cop. This is all similar to any percent. So what you want to do is in this car chase is you want to basically cut the militia vehicle off and smash into him after you cut him off. So back on my old computer, it was a thing to go too quickly, but I find on this new computer that I got that actually, if I literally just stay as kind of close to the right of the side of the road as reasonably possible, I always get him. So when you have better load times like I do on this computer, he always fires basically like right at this intersection, which is what you want. And then he will always turn into this alley right here. On my old computer, it was possible to go too fast where he fires it before he gets to that. So you have to kind of finesse it a bit. But on this computer, I never have that happen anymore. So that's just one thing to call out. If you find yourself that he turns into this corner, if he doesn't turn into the corner, then you need to like slow down a bit. If he does turn into the corner, but you don't, he doesn't blow up the police car as quickly as you want, then it's because you're going too slow. So if you're going too slow, stay on the right side of the road. If you're going too fast, go a little bit to the left side of the road. but I was kind of perfect here. So just like any percent, we will smash into him here. Hopefully I don't miss it. That'll be very embarrassing. Oh, I missed it. Okay. I'm gonna try it again. That was a little embarrassing. But if you reload and try it again, it's much harder. It doesn't. Yeah, so it doesn't look like I'm gonna get it. Like, you have to hold forward, hold forward right when the loading screen ends.
Oscar 5-6, this is Commissioner Gordon. I'm calling off the pursuit. It's too dangerous. Sir,
right. Yeah, so this is an example of going too slow. If you go too slowly, one thing you can do, I saw some people do this, which is turn here, and then you'll still be able to cut him off here. And yeah, so this actually is not a bad place to take him out. And so here, what you can usually do is you can cancel this interrogation. So see if I can do it. So that's how you cancel on controller. You'll see me cancel on. You saw me cancel on keyboard earlier. So it's good that I got to kind of showcase that.
Where is he? I got nothing to say to you, Batman. Talk, or I'll crush every bone in your body.
Okay, okay. Working out of a penthouse in Chinatown. I swear that's all I know.
If you're lying, I'll break the other one.
The other one?
Ah! Okay, so the next thing we'll do is before we go to Ivy, we will scan this riddle here. So it's this this is the Deacon Blackfire riddle, so we scan that and press escape twice to get out of the riddle menu. And then in this fight we'll do the same kind of as any percent, throw the smoke, you can do four takedown cancels here and take out four guys really quickly, and then the rest of these guys, because we have critical strikes, we can kind of do this, we can just punch people. Otherwise, you would normally do takedown cancels. This part is the same as any percent, so there are these two shields we can shoot. So one is, this is Dixon Dock, and the other one is this Skyway here. Look down and go here, and this spawns the tanks in better spots usually. Alright, this is all standard. We don't do the diagnostics. We will just go into there and quickly abort it. And then the next thing we do is this firefighter. Firefighters are interesting because you can cancel the part where you like rescue them. So we'll kind of see what that looks like, but it has some weird characteristics. So first we'll take these guys out. It is better to if you get these guys clustered and put the smoke in the right spot, you can take down cancel all five of them, which is ideal, but it doesn't always work. And so yeah, now we can cancel this guy. So one thing is that, again, when you cancel, a lot of times it's going to grapple instead. One way to avoid that is to zoom in onto the guy and then do the cancel. And then what we're going to do is the reason why we cancel these is, so in general, when you cancel it, if you leave the area, the game teleports you back to the firefighter when the cutscene starts. So we're going to like take advantage of that. So the way we take advantage of that is we want to kind of grapple this light post and get a trophy while we do this. And then once we get the trophy, it'll teleport us back to here and then we can continue. The exception is actually also if you cancel a firefighter and then go into the Batmobile, the game keeps you in the Batmobile even after the cutscene. It's kind of funny. So we're going to make use of both of these. I'll try to do this here. This one's can be kind of tricky. I'm not very well practiced with it. Okay, so I didn't get it. So, but basically what you want to do is get this trophy in this crate. This will take some practice, but basically what you do is you would cancel him, then glide into this crate here, and then get the trophy. And then it's a little bit tight, even with the right movement. And after you get it, ideally it teleports you back into here. So then you can then just jump out of here, get in your Batmobile. So now we have the Panessa tank fight. Before we do that, we shoot the shield here. So that's the right before Panessa tank fight. For this, if you notice, we saved our missile barrage from the previous tank fight, so we use it immediately and then build it back up. It's kind of important to have your missile barrage because we're going to use it in our next objective. And then, also if you notice in these tank fights, you have the Vulcan gun, so that's basically just this machine gun that Batman shoots, and what I like to do is alternate between use the Vulcan gun whenever the main cannon is charging. Or is recharging. So that's just kind of how we do it. So it's like that, and then you can, if you shoot the glowing parts of the tanks, you can one-shot them basically. So that's kind of how you should do tank fights. So then the next thing we do is there's a shield right here. So this is the Panessa gate. Then we'll go up here. There's a trophy up here, so what I do is, so usually what the idea is, if you face the camera this way, Batman should sometimes get out of the Batmobile on this side that you're facing the camera. It doesn't always work. In fact, a lot of times it doesn't work. But that's what I try to do. And jump down here, there's a trophy down here, so this is the, House Bridge, Panessa. Then I like to boost out of here and glide over to this. Oops. We'll glide over to this pig victim right here. And so this pig victim is. So this is ear. So the ear is right here. Abdomen. Haysock. And then hip. So it's very close, but it's on the hip. So our Batmobile is kind of far away. What I've started doing is grappling onto this traffic light and then just going to the Batmobile. So there's a shield right here. That is the Northeast Bridge, Panessa. And then there's on the way to Panessa, there's a trophy here. So this is the Cord Building. So that's why it says Cord Building near GCPD, because this is the Cord Building near GCPD. Then we go to GCPD.
Good to have you here, Batman. Bring her down to the lockup on the lower level.
So the next thing we get it sorry the next thing we get is the ret gun. The reason why we get it is because we need it for some trophies. It has nothing to do with zips, because we're not going to do any zips. Well, we will do zips. We're not going to do any zips in the near future, but the first thing we do is get the ret gun. We get this in all categories right now. It's too useful to have. Plus, it's required to have in this category. It's not in the trackers, but you really should get it now. Then there's... So then to get the ret gun, what I do is I dive roll into it. So when I get to about here, I use this as a visual cue, and then I dive roll into it to get it. And then likewise here, I dive roll into this trophy and then get it. And the dive roll cue is basically right here. I like to then dive roll into this cutscene. And yeah, this cutscene is just not too much to say about it.
Damn bureaucrats. We're on our own. We can handle it, Jim. What's the latest? We've got incidents cropping up all over the city. Cash, give us a rundown.
All right, let's see. First up, we've lost contact with the fire
crew. Well, and the other thing to notice is that we got the... the GCPD trophy, but it hasn't updated. The reason why is because we haven't gotten an autosave. So this is an example of a trophy that we get that basically what would happen is if we reloaded here, we would have to get that trophy again. So I kind of find it useful, but it does make it harder to know what you have or haven't gotten when the tracker doesn't necessarily update.
Look, I know you're busy, but anything you can do to help is going to save lives.
So here you have to select a side mission or the main mission. I usually select the firefighter mission just because that's where my cursor is. So now we see it updated, and then what we're going to do is there's this Jack Ryder riddle here. Scan him. I switched to my explosive gel now because we're going to do an animation cancel very soon. And then, so here what you can do is, just, if you cancel at the right time, there's a fairly small window to cancel it, but it's not that bad, but you can get in the car immediately, off of the cancel. And then Lucius enables the afterburner. The afterburner is very important, especially in Riddler races. And then, the key feature about this game is that if you drift, so in this on this keyboard, the drifting is basically when you turn and hold shift, you do that. It's called a power slide, I guess, but it's also what we call it also drifting. And if you notice, it recharges the afterburner very quickly. So when you're driving, it's good to keep this in mind. If you ever need more afterburner and want to recharge it quickly, is to drift. The other feature about drifting is that while you're drifting, it does slow down the timer in Riddler races and in challenge maps. We'll get to those then. Anyways, the movement to get to the clock tower, so I do like to drift here. And then at this corner, I also like to drift. Then I get into tank mode and get out, so that way that avoids this animation where Batman like jumps out of his car. Grapple the Scargoyle. Then grapple up to the clock tower. I get into detective vision just to see where the door is more easily, and make sure you're in detective vision when you come down here, because that's required. And then here we're going to do the animation cancel to skip a little animation where he opens up the statue. Interact with this. There's a thing you can do here is when you skip the dialogue, crouch when he's putting his thing away, and then you basically skip a little animation where he like puts his like video thing away on his wrist. It's a little bit faster than just waiting for that or even punching through it. Hey, Camille, I did not see what you said yesterday. So now we will go to Panessa. So the movement is to want to. I dive 2 seconds and then grapple the left side of this thing here, and then glide or cancel, and then you can glide all the way over there. So grapple here, I like to cancel and then dive bomb here. And so here, Lucius is gonna give us the power winch, but before we actually get the power winch, what we're going to do is get a trophy and a shield. So grapple here. This is kind of a hard grapple cancel. But I recommend practicing it. It's very useful to kind of get to this area over here quickly. You'll lose time at the start, but I think it's worth it in the long run to get good at that. If you want to see more detailed movements about this area, I think my Any% of my glitchless tutorial cover that. I think here I want to focus a little less on optimal movement and more on kind of the collectibles and other kind of strats. But yeah, definitely check out the Any% tutorial for those kinds of specifics. So for this trophy, there's a trophy basically right here. I try to glide to like the edge of this part right here, and you can quick fire this and then jump in and call your Batmobile. One thing that I found that's really weird is that you can't like call you can't like glide and call the Batmobile from here. That's why I fall and call the Batmobile. It's very weird. Also, once you get in the Batmobile, you're not able to zoom in for a bit, so this shield can be very annoying to shoot without being able to zoom in, but we'll get it. But that's the next collectible. Make sure like if you don't have the tracker, make sure that you actually make sure that you've shot the shield. That's like a very common thing. Is that you don't sometimes you just miss the shield and you don't realize it because it's like a lot of times with Riddler trophies, there's a text that pops up that says that you got that Riddler trophy, but with the shields, you don't get that, so you don't necessarily know if you've gotten it. So that's a very common thing. So definitely check the tracker and make sure that you actually got that shield. If you're on console, just maybe wait like an extra second or something to make sure that you actually shot the shield, unless you're really confident that you got it. But like it, sometimes like you might be very confident and you just never got it. So when we pull this down, so there's something called Fenris Jump, which basically what we're supposed to do is we're supposed to get to this objective over there. And what we can do is we can theoretically have the Batmobile bounce off of that railing right there and get to that objective. I'm not going to do that, but optimally you would do it right now. I'm not really going to go over it. I tried doing it in my other tutorials and I didn't get it, so I'll just go over do this the intended way. Here, even if you are doing this the intended way, so some people like you're able to pull this ramp all the way up and it will stay up for the rest of the run, but whereas if you don't pull it all the way up, it won't stay up. But I find it takes about 8 seconds to pull the ramp all the way up, and you're only ever going to need this ramp if you do the Fenris jump, you only need this ramp twice, and if you don't do the Fenris jump, you need it 3 times. And if you pull it for 2 seconds, that's all you need for it to be able to clear this. So because you only need to do it 3 times, that's 6 seconds. So it's not actually worth it to pull it up all the way. Plus, the Batmobile jump itself is a little bit slower when you pull it up all the way. So I recommend not pulling it up all the way. It's just slower. And then we go here. There is a collectible right here. I don't have it routed in right now, just because I'm kind of future-proofing the route. So that if we ever actually do Fenris jump, it'll still work. And there's also a trophy like in the wall over there, which we actually deliberately don't get until later. But anyway, so these two collectibles here, we won't get them yet. We'll get them in kind of the second half of the next time we come back to this area. This is all intended. One thing I've seen people like to do if they're not comfortable with the resulting grapple, so the grapple cancel, is to power the antenna from right here. But that is slower, so I don't do that. I just power it whenever I'm able to like interact with it. Alright, so I get to about here, then zoom in here, and then grapple here. This cancel is very, very, very annoying sometimes, especially from certain angles. The ideal angle is one where Batman doesn't get too close to the wall, like I did there, because it's much harder to see where to cancel. And it's, as you can see, it's like even I'm messing it up. It happens all the time. And that's why a lot of people do like to go closer to that, so that it makes this cancel much easier. I don't know why it's not working though, but it's... there we go. So that's the cancel we want to get. It's not easy. Over here, we're going to do the dialogue overlapping thing. So where basically what you do is you grapple on this gargoyle, cancel it, then... Oh, whoops. Let's try it again. But basically, you're supposed to grapple up there and trigger some dialogue. But we can overlap some of the dialogue to save a little bit of time. So what you do is grapple over here, and then cancel it, and then grapple back, and then you'll be overlapping this dialogue over here. Armed. If I alert them, they'll kill Scarecrow's men or guarding the end. If I can separate them, they'll be easier to five soldiers. So yeah, throw your batarang. It's gonna lure the two guys out, and we'll do canceled silent takedowns on them. We went over takedown cancels earlier. So suit up, we'll do this fear takedown, and then after the fear takedown, we're going to do two animation cancels, one to interact with the cop, and the other to interact with the antenna. So make sure you have your gel selected, do the cancel here. And then that saves about like 20 seconds to do those two cancels.
I need to use both antennas to identify the micro and radio wave frequencies across Gotham. If I can find both frequencies at the same location, I'll know where
Scarecrow. So here, point the antennas to Ace Chemicals, which is on the right.
Frequencies point to Ace Chemicals. That's where Scarecrow's producing the toxin.
Yeah, so if you look at the tracker, so next there's a Riddler trophy, and then we'll do our first Riddler race. Ever since the evacuation
started, just like you asked. Crane must have bought them off. Or worse.
So I boost, get, call the Batmobile. Batman gets into the Batmobile pretty quickly. So here you pull this train. I pull it all the way. I'm not sure if you have to. Then eject out of the Batmobile. Go to here. It's the trophy is right under here. And then to get back to the Batmobile, I boost off of here. And then get into the Batmobile like that. Probably refine that movement, but I like it. So the thing about these Riddler races is that you have to take an elevator down to all of them. The elevator ride, if Riddler isn't talking, takes about 30 seconds. But Riddler has different dialogues in these elevators, and some of them are longer than others. So the Riddler has dialogues. The vast majority of them cause the elevator to slow down so that you can kind of listen to Riddler's dialogue before the elevator actually gets to the bottom. I think all of the Riddler dialogues but one are like that. So what we're going to do is we want to actually cancel Riddler's dialogue. And the way that we do that is we go to the Riddler menu. So wait till Riddler pops up on the screen and then go to the Riddle menu and select an unsolved riddle. Now, the thing is that not all of the riddles are revealed. So like this one's not revealed. This one's not revealed. This one is revealed. This one's revealed. This one's revealed. This one's revealed. This one's not. So get familiar with which riddles are revealed and which ones aren't at the time you're skipping these Riddler dialogues. So one riddle that's very safe is this one, because this is a riddle that we have routed very, very late into the run. But this one, Souvenir, this is also very safe on Bleak. This one works now, but basically the one I do is I choose this one just because it's the closest to my cursor. So one other thing is that if you're in this menu and you can get an upgrade, you should. We actually can't get our multi-ground takedown upgrade yet because if we end up routing in more Riddler trophies into this, then you would get this. You would be able to afford an upgrade, but right now we can't. So, we'll do that the next time we skip one of these dialogues. After we get enough upgrade points. So the next dialogues are, there's basically a thing where Riddler goes through a bunch of rules. But then the intended mechanic of the game is for you to basically figure out that you're supposed to be, that you can hack the gate codes and then unlock it, which surprises him, or you can have him read through a bunch of like 10 rules, which is like really funny. And it's like 2 minutes long or something. Then you can open the gate codes. And what we're going to do is, so if we skip Riddler's dialogue right now, it basically goes to the end of that like two or three minute dialogue. And it's faster than getting the Riddler codes the intended way, which is, and then cancel this dialogue again. And then cancel this dialogue. But the next dialogue we won't cancel. The one where it's like counting down here, canceling that dialogue doesn't speed up the countdown. It's better to just let this play. So in these Riddler races, so one thing that I do in a lot of them, or in this one especially, is go into first person. Because I have a really hard time driving on the side of walls or upside down when I'm in third person. It's just not intuitive to me. But whereas in first person, the camera will follow you if you're driving on the side of walls, which makes it much easier. So if you're having trouble with Riddler races, this is likely a reason why. I highly recommend doing first person if you can. Here, eventually... In the middle of the second lap, Batman will disable this afterburner recharge. Also, I go to the left. I think that's faster. But until then, yeah. So drifting here, you'll notice when you drift, the timer on the top here turns green and slows down. So that's kind of the drifting mechanic, the main point of it. If you're doing challenge maps and you're not having trouble with it, that's probably the reason why. But anyways, this first lap is very slow just because we don't have the full afterburner. Because the afterburner runs out, but eventually Batman disables that, which makes it quite a bit faster.
I'm disabling the afterburner's failsafe.
Yeah, the failsafe. And then, so in general, you actually want to be using the afterburner as much as possible, because, so that was a little bit of a mistake, and that was for sometimes. So what you can do is, if you're boosting, you don't have to toggle that last thing, that last obstacle. I got a little scared, so I did toggle it, which turned out to be a mistake. Yeah, and if you want to unlock the challenge map, you make sure you boost very hard off of that. Yeah, because we have infinite afterburner, drifting in general doesn't really matter unless you're like going around a corner and it makes it. Yeah, so you don't need to do it. Unfortunately, it also didn't pay off there. I still flipped over. It's just fine. This is a really flexible Riddler race. You have plenty of time to finish it. And this one is always a little tricky. If you mistime that, you can get blown up very easily. And yeah, now we got our upgrade points, so when we go into the elevator, we can do two things. We can skip Riddler's dialogue, and then we can also get the next upgrade, which is the multi-ground takedown, which we can afford now. I would highly recommend getting this one. There is an argument to be made for getting the reload speed if you're on controller, just to make tank fights a little easier, but I still highly recommend getting the combat upgrade instead. So next, we will head over to Ace. On the way, we will get a few trophies. So we will drive there because we're, one is faster, two we're in our car already. I like to eject. I like to go over here and eject at Dixon Docks. And there is a thing here, you can glide into it. It's very possible to like miss this glide. So like for example, I missed it deliberately. The alternative, you can try gliding around again, but one thing you can do is you can, if you alternate fire your explosive, just alternate fire is a middle mouse button or on controller it's the right button. So if you alternate fire onto that, you'll actually blow it up. So if you ever miss these kinds of glides, instead of trying to glide back around, just go down, alternate fire into the planks, and then it'll blow up, and then you can just grapple up and get the trophy. Okay, so there's a fireman right here, so I like to boost off of some roof here, and then go to the fireman with a little dive bomb. Here I like to do to get a double fear takedown here. Then fear takedown these guys. Then if you do two critical strikes after, you can multi-ground takedown. So now here, you can cancel this firefighter. Boost off of here and get this trophy here. And then what you can do is, if it's, this is kind of precise where you can grapple off here, you can go backwards a little bit and then grapple off here and then cancel it. If you miss the trophy, then just go over to here, and then what you can do is, this one's a little easier, you grapple off the same thing and cancel it. So I did it wrong. What you want to do is when you're boosting off of this, do only one. You want to do only the grapple boost mark one. So only where you have the only one bar over here, and then you'll be able to go in here, run in here, scan this riddle, and then one thing you'll see people do is if you want to zoom, it's all. Like after you're like while you're running, you're not necessarily able to zoom immediately. But if you aim a gadget, you're able to zoom immediately. So the reason why you'll see a lot of 100% runners aim a gadget is for that reason. And here I zoom specifically to try to get a better grapple point, so we can get this trophy. But yeah, the thing where we aim the gadget and then zoom to scan something or do something, it's very common in all of these Arkham games. So I highly recommend every time you scan every time you intend to scan a riddle, aim a gadget, typically the Batarang. All right, so we go here. You can kind of get the trophy from here as well. It's a little bit faster. I like to switch to my line launcher while grappling over here. And then we do Ace Chemicals. So Ace Chemicals is identical to any percent, except we do have the crew left in there, but they're not responding in the facility. We do have the multi-ground takedown, which makes some of it faster, but it's not too different. So again, we do the same thing where we skip the cutscene where we would grapple up to Ace Chemicals. We do a grapple cancel here, and this is possible on controller. It's just much harder. If you're doing this on controller, you'll need to practice this a lot, or you don't even have to go for it. So there's an argument for not doing the fear takedown here. I still do it. But one thing you could do is you could do a regular takedown and then try to make use of your multi-ground takedown there. But I think doing it the regular any percent way is perfectly fine. So open this. And if you recall, we have our missile barrage because we built it up back in our last tank fight at Panessa. So what we'll do is just go in here, just like an any percent, use our missile barrage immediately and then shoot the last tank. And aim, make sure you're facing the camera a bit to the left. That way you'll destroy this tank, and this tank. Usually, sometimes you'll destroy this tank here, but most of the time you won't. And then you can turn around and destroy that tank. That's the same as any percent. So then we go to the next worker, which is, oops. Very standard. I found that you can, if you're like right here and you just boost, you're like lined up pretty well with this. Something I'm going to start incorporating in my runs. It'll be a little faster than finessing through that area. Yeah, shoot these guys and then go to this worker. When he says keep your, that's when you can RC your, that's when you can RC your Batmobile. Shoot as many of these guys as possible, so RC your car, and shoot as many of these guys as you can. That's the fastest way. but sometimes it doesn't work. Sometimes they like are really aggressive and spot you, but it's fine. We also have critical strikes, so you can back it up in the fight a lot faster than you would in. We have multi-ground actually, but you also have critical strikes. You can just punch them. It's fine. I guess in any percent, we would also have critical strikes at this point. So. Okay, so we do this the same Ace Chemical skips. You can do all of them. There are no collectibles in here that we need to worry about. No collectibles in here at all. So again, in any percent, it's the same thing. So you go over here, glide onto these pipes. Make sure you're facing at about this angle. Dive roll into here. And then you can 1, 2, 3, and pull. Usually you won't make it all the way, or you won't have enough speed to make it all the way, so do a second dive bomb for a little bit. I only do like one or a second or so, and then when you turn around, go in here. Make sure that you don't exit the elevator too early, I guess. Make sure it's actually loaded, like the people are loaded in before you exit. Otherwise you soft lock your game and have to load in a backup save. This is all standard, but the one thing is that this fight is a bit faster because you do have multi-ground. So generally the way that you use multi-ground is you want to batarang people. So the idea is if you do kind of like punch, batarang, and then multi-ground, basically your batarang will take out three people usually, and your punch takes out one person, or it knocks them down to the ground, and then multi-ground will take out those four people. If you do punch, batarang, punch, that will be five people, and then punch, batarang, then multi-ground, that's eight people. So you kind of want to do that kind of pattern, be aware of that, try to take as many people out with the multi-ground as possible in general. There are two ninjas in this fight. On easy, ninjas are not really a big deal, whereas on like hard and even normal and new game plus, they're a much bigger deal. But yeah, here we're going to use multi-ground, but we will start with a fear takedown. I like to try to target this ninja here as the second guy, and then the medic as the third guy. It's not hugely important, especially in 100% where you have multi-ground, but this ninja can revive people if you don't pay attention to him, which will make the fight slower. Then here I did the punch batarang thing. Oops. Yeah, so that was a little unfortunate getting hit by the ninja, but it happens.
Jim, I've rescued the second worker. I'm coming to you.
What about Scarecrow?
He's in the...
Is it...
So here, this is a standard any percent, so you just RC your Batmobile and then rescue... Then you can just take the just drive out to the entrance. And you've rescued both workers, the game gets a little confused. And then to get Batman back in the Batmobile, you want to reload from checkpoint. That's the fastest way to get him back in the Batmobile.
Scarecrow's forces have murdered the other workers.
Bastards.
Take them back to GC.
So then you can do the second Ace Chemical skip, so if you're not familiar with it, you eject from your Batmobile, go over to these pipes again. Make sure you're facing the right way.
I need the Batmobile to get back in there and find Scarecrow.
So the easiest, fast way of doing this is to do your dive bomb, then go here and use the line launcher tightrope. This was actually wrong. Okay. If that happens, there's a nice backup, which is to you grapple over to here. So basically that happened because I line launched tightroped too far to the left. Then what you can do is you grapple over here, you can then go over to this area, make sure that this thing in front of you is loaded in, but then you can line launch and then go on the tightrope, go about right here, and then go over here and then turn left, and then this area loads in. I like to grapple then to this grapple point. Cancel it fairly early, otherwise you'll ledge grab, and then go over to here. There's some backups, or some other backups, like if you mess up certain things. I recommend looking at the Any% tutorial. I don't want to go over them right now, and on this run. Ace Chemical Skip is a little bit, like, less critical, I think, in this run. But yeah, if you want a more detailed thing about all of the how to do Ace Chemical Skip, all the backups, like if the ceiling deloads too early, or you get a different grapple point, what exactly you should do. Yeah, check out the Any% tutorial. I'll have it linked in the description below. So here, this predator is, you do it the standard way, cancel this guy. Bat claw these guys down here. I've started not takedown canceling this guy. Gives me time also to make sure that there's nobody coming down the ladder. If somebody is coming down the ladder, you take them out. You take them out in a different way. Blow this guy up, and then I started really liking throwing a smoke here. Sometimes the guys are clustered up, and then you can fear takedown them. Once I clear the room, this guy, take out this guy, so. It appears that the flow of chemical.
Alfred.
So here again, so this is also the same as Any% where you can cancel these canisters. So
I'm not trying to stop it.
We'll go ahead and do that. The blast radius.
And what will happen to you?
That doesn't matter. Find her, Alfred.
Neutralizing agent deployed.
If you miss a cancel, so what the cancel looks like is it looks like this. You can run on keyboard very easily. If you're on controller, you can also run, so long as you don't hold the joystick all the way. Then you put them in. You can be as aggressive as you want with putting them in. Just be very careful, because if you put it in too quickly, you lose 5 seconds, because basically there's like a thing that, like, tries to make sure you don't put it in too quickly, and there's like an animation that happens when you do that. If you, let's say, miss a cancel, you lose it loses about like 20 seconds, which is annoying, but in 100% it doesn't matter too much. But yeah, if you're on keyboard, if you're on 30 FPS, you can literally just mash forward and space. If you're on, if you're actually at 60 FPS, you need to mash a little bit slower, because I think on 60 FPS the inputs are a bit more responsive, so you need to be a bit more careful about that. And yeah, be as aggressive as you need to be with pushing it. I like to try to be a bit more aggressive, try to make sure I get fast beeping, but it's very risky to do that. So be mindful. And we'll cancel this. Yeah, you should cancel the first three. I just wanted to demonstrate what to do if you miss the cancel.
That's all that matters.
Master Bruce, I implore you, you must get out of there. If this is about Miss Gordon, you cannot blame yourself for what's happened. Save yourself before it's too late.
Goodbye, Alfred.
And this last one you can't cancel, so don't. Yeah, so here, it's nothing really special, just walk through this door.
I supposed to get in?
Voice pattern analyzed. Identification confirmed. Welcome, Commissioner Gordon.
Unbelievable.
All right, so when you interact with the Jokers, I go counterclockwise. It's faster to do that. And I look at the ground. Basically, you want to be inside of so there's a visual cue I have, basically, so that you're far enough away from them but still able to interact with the doors. So what it is like, what you can kind of see, it's basically you want to be on this like outer semicircle right here, and like, so if you're right here, you know, you can talk. If you're a little bit farther, you can't. If you're too close, then you're just going in a bigger, you're just taking a longer path. So I find the sweet spot is this semicircle here. So just do that and spam the interact button, and then head over to Henry Adams.
Commissioner, thank God. You have to get me out of here. They've locked me up, running tests like I'm some kind of guinea pig. There's nothing wrong with me.
Spin your camera around to get this little jump scare.
You need to see this. What is this place? Who are
So here, as I guess on 30 FPS, I'm not sure, I don't remember 60, but yeah, I RC the Batmobile sometime after Joker wags his finger. And so then here, what you'll do is, there are going to be two militia people and a sentry gun. If you kill or if you destroy all three of them, you get a dialogue with Gordon. So try to avoid doing that. The easiest way is to stay on the right side of the road and not destroy the sentry gun. And then there are these tanks. Finesse your way through these tanks. And you can get a damage boost, which you will get shot. Sometimes the damage boost is helpful. Sometimes it's really unhelpful, like it was right there. Most of the time it's kind of neutral, I guess. But yeah, and so that's Ace Chemicals. It's pretty much the same as any percent, no collectibles. If you want kind of a... So if you're familiar with it in any percent, then... Yeah, it's not, there are no real differences. So now on the way back, what we will do is, on the way to GCPD, so there's a trophy right here. So I like to be about right here. Zoom in. It's hard to see, but there's a wall that you can shoot right here and then glide to it. And then there's a firefighter. So the cool thing about this firefighter is it's very close to this Riddler bomb. And when you do this Riddler bomb, we'll go over the Riddler bomb a bit. So we'll do this fight here. So fear takedown, and then try to get the rest of the guys taken out with the multi-ground. And then we do want to cancel this firefighter. So when you do the Riddler bomb, there's this really long Riddler like dialogue that happens, and we can't actually like cancel it because you're not able to pull up any menus. So what we want to try to do is overlap that with something. So what we'll do is we're gonna make use of this canceling thing. So what we do is canceling thing, and then if we go over to this Riddler bomb, Then we'll start the dialogue, and then we get teleported back to the firefighter. And then what we can do is use our RC Batarang right now to try to find the Riddler bomb victim. Keep an eye on him. Sometimes they can run away. But do not shoot him until Riddler's dialogue ends. If you shoot him before Riddler's dialogue ends, it doesn't work. So that's the very real important thing. It'll disable the explosive. So I like to just wait for the zoom in to be safe. Those thugs won't let me near. And then so you're intended to use your RC Batarang and use like electricity, but you can also just retgun him. You can retgun him. You can use an electrically charged RC Batarang. Or you can use your Batmobile to just drive into him. All three of those work for rescuing this Riddler bomb. But yeah, that's the Riddler bomb. So let's say though that it is possible, like you might not get the cancel. Then one other thing you can do, it's a bit harder. If you want to also save time on these Riddler bombs, so I'm gonna just boot in a backup save for it. So we'll go to the Riddler bomb here, and so what you can do is, if you get on this pad and then throw your RC Batarang at the right time, then you can actually break out of the animation. And then what you can do is, if you have your RC Batarang like face away from this area, then you're able to actually scan these guys while this is happening. Now this is risky because sometimes, like, your camera is locked, so here you can't actually look at the Riddler bomb person, and he might like run away or be in a completely different spot from where you found him, and then you might not be able to find him. And I've had this happen a bunch of times before, so this strat where you throw the RC Batarang early is tough. It's a judgment call. This Riddler bomb usually doesn't run away, so it's fine. But yeah, then you shoot him, and then what, things are good. So I guess this save file didn't finish the firefighter, so we'll just do that. Oops. Yeah, unfortunately, we do have to do this firefighter again, because it didn't autosave, I guess.
What the hell happened? I don't remember anything. Your truck was attacked.
It's over.
So normally what we would do is we can go do this Clock Tower Predator. It's pretty much the same, except the enemy positions are a little bit different. So kind of adjust your strat based on the enemy positioning. But yeah, so usually what you do is you take out... Just take out Sky. I only did this, not for safety reasons, just to get a quick takedown on him. Then what we want to do is grapple off this, boost off of it. There is a trophy, so the crappy building, it's this crappy building. It's like really crappy. It's really busted up. Get this trophy. And then we have kind of the worst strat in the run, which is to basically what you want to do is, there's a fight here. This fight can take a long time because there's like, it's like kind of hard, Given how few gadget upgrades you have, like there's shield guys, there are stun stick guys, you haven't really learned how to deal with them. So it's not the easiest fight, and it can be kind of slow. One thing we can do is we can, if we go here though, and we aggro them, and then go over here. So make sure you go over this side of the railing, otherwise this skip is much less consistent. But basically, go over here, grab this trophy, and then if you just wait here, usually these guys will all just run away. And depending on how risky you want to be, you can grapple up kind of based on like based on how far away these guys are. And then hopefully these guys don't run back. That's a thing that can happen. Interact with this guy as quickly as you're able to. Sometimes what happens is you're able to interact with him, but if you're too slow, then one of the guys might come back and you have to fight him. It's very annoying.
Thanks, Batman. Where are the others? Tell me they're okay.
Don't worry, I'm getting them.
Alright, so now what we'll do is we'll get two upgrades. So we'll get the two tank upgrades. So we'll get reload speed and body shot. So like some people might want to get turret shot. One thing is I already have turret shot because I have the booster pack, but even in general, I'd still recommend body shot first because you're not going to get any tanks that require the turret shot until later. Right now all of your tanks are regular rattlers, and body shot, it just makes it much easier to deal with them in practice. So I recommend getting reload speed and body shot, particularly because we have a couple of tank fights coming up with rattlers. Yeah, so one little trick is to run into the GCPD and call your Batmobile, and the Batmobile won't turn around. That's just a little thing. Then, talk to Gordon. Yeah, this car chase is same as any percent.
Jim, I need you to stay focused.
Basically, you want to destroy the two cars before Arkham Knight starts talking. It is possible to destroy them too quickly, but you can work around that, ideally. And it's not a big deal. It's better to destroy them quickly than slowly on average, because if you destroy them slowly, you have to rely on Gordon driving in the right spot. So it's just a little easier to destroy them quickly or like immediately like that. If you destroy them really quickly like this, try to drive quickly and block Gordon from turning in a direction, and then you can also get into tank mode a few times in and out, and then you can actually push Gordon to like a better spot. Anyways, we have this.
Just get us there in one piece, Batman. We're running out of time. What have you got, Alfred?
So here we can do this dialogue skip on keyboard where we just move this and then press spacebar and then move this again, press spacebar when Alfred talks, move this again, and then press spacebar when Alfred talks again. That's a little dialogue skip. It saves quite a bit of time, like 20 seconds or something. Now we will go to the clock tower and do this tank fight. So this tank fight is very nice to have the body shot and reload speed. So that's why we get it now. I like to missile barrage in the middle of it. It's a little bit faster. And then after the tank fight, go over here and do this trophy. So this trophy, you pull this back. And then ret gun it. So this is why we need the ret gun for trophies like this. Here, you can run. I think you're supposed to mash space a few times and then hold it.
Colleen? Is that you again?
Candy Gram! Oh, don't pass out just yet. Come on. Show a little spy. Just wait till your father gets home. He's going to be furious about all this mess.
Okay, so look over here, look over here, and then it's in the clock tower.
Like a trip down old memory lane, eh, Bats? And now a front row seat to the main event.
So here we're going to do the same thing that we do in Glitchless, where we skip a Joker dialogue by reloading right when we get this next autosave.
You really should tell him this is your fault, Bats. I'm sure he'll understand. I mean, it's not like he went out and got his daughter killed. Well, not yet anyway. The night's...
Yeah, so what we do is so we look away, try to spawn in the wheelchair. And then I look away twice and try to spawn it in twice, because sometimes the first time you're not able to interact with it. But anyways, we do this, skip the cutscene, and then reload. And then basically we get these loading screens, and right when the loading screen ends, hold forward and then for a little bit, and then mash space, and then you'll be able to interact more quickly with the computer.
I need to find out what happened. Like that. They covered their tracks by disabling the clock tower security.
If you have like a mouse where you can adjust the DPI, definitely adjust it so that it's like really, really high. So, and then you can do this part really quickly.
There. That's the vehicle they took Barbara away in. Those tires are Amortech D60s. I can program the Batmobile to track their unique tread pattern. It'll lead me right to them.
Okay, so we will start tracking Oracle now.
Now that I think about it, how did Scarecrow know to go after your IT department? I mean, I had no idea she worked for you when I shot her. I just got lucky.
The tire tracks will lead me to Barbara.
If you scan that at the right time, you can scan the tire tracks a little bit at the start. I missed it, so that's unfortunate, but... And then what we do is there's this trophy, so grab this with your Batmobile and then shoot that while you're pulling it. That's just a little micro optimization. Run in here. You don't need to pull these all the way, but you do need to pull it some of the way. Otherwise, Batman can't really go through it. I'm gonna go here. Then continue scanning the tracks. So, So one thing is that there is a shield right near here that you can shoot. So I'll just shoot it. You can shoot it before or after the fight. I think it might be faster to shoot it after the fight, but shooting it before, make sure you don't forget it. It's up to you. And yeah, and then you can aim and shoot at the shield now, if and then blow up the bomb. And then what we're going to do is we're going to not actually continue scanning the tire tracks, because you don't need to. We're going to do a skip to get past the next part. Before we do that, Skip, there's a shoot a breakable wall here. It's very hard to see, but you can shoot it there. And then eject from the Batmobile and get... So there's a trophy right here. And then what I like to do here is I like to line launch to here. Because you don't have to do anything. He'll just climb it automatically. And now one very important thing about routing this game is that you notice that we have 22 riddles solved right now. And then when we get to the Catwoman riddle, we will have 23 riddles. It's very important right now to only have 22 riddles solved or 24. But having 23 riddles solved is very bad. I'll explain why later. But basically, if you're ever rerouting any trophies, make sure to not have 23 riddles solved by this point. So I deliberately have routed it so that we have 22 riddles solved. But if you ever want to add more riddles to it, you want to have 24 riddles solved, not 23. 24 or more. There's this pig victim here. So scan the chest. This is the one rare pig victim where you're able to scan this next part immediately as opposed to waiting for Batman's dialogue. And occasionally you're able to scan this part immediately, but very rarely. I've only been able to have that once. So it's a weird feature about this game. So now we're gonna head to Riddler. The way we do that is there's a wall over here that has no collision. So we glide into that. And then we will 2, 3 and pull. Dive bomb, get maximum speed and go in this direction. So what we're trying to head to the orphanage. So basically we were right here, and now we're trying to head to right here. What we're going to do is we're going to glide and grapple a pier right here. And then when we cancel that, that gives us enough speed to get to the orphanage. So that's basically what we're trying to do here. So grapple it like right about here. And then you'll be able to cancel. And then you have enough speed to get to the door of this orphanage. So there are two ways you can... there are two ways you can do this. So the best way is the fastest way is to just cancel this door. So what a door cancel is, I already show you the animation cancels where basically you aim and alt fire and then hold aim again. Door cancel is the same thing except you don't have to hold aim at the end. So it's just that. So the best way is to do this is to door cancel it. If you aren't good at door canceling, it's a bit harder, but what you can do, I haven't done this in forever, but what you can also do is you can also just open this door regularly, hold back and for a little bit, and then if you hold back too much, Batman will fall into the void. If you hold back a little bit for about as much as I held, Batman will be standing on basically an invisible floor that isn't actually loaded. And then you can open it again. Be very careful when you do this because you can soft lock. If you reload, you can reload when you're out of bounds, and then there's nothing you can really do. Door canceling is the safer option. It avoids all of that. But yeah, door canceling is the actual way. So this is what a door cancel would normally look like. Yeah, so don't door cancel that. That was just to show you what it would look like. We'll do other door cancels later. And so now what we'll do is we'll do this fight. This fight is straightforward, especially with critical strikes. Just make use of your critical strikes. I also like to Batclaw Slam the first robot just because it gets me closer to the fight. And then two critical strikes takes them out. And then you can then what we do is skip this Riddler dialogue. You can skip both of these, and then scan Catwoman's collar. You have time. And the thing is that we have scanned Catwoman's collar as the 23rd riddle. And the reason why we explicitly want it to not be the 24th riddle is that the 24th riddle triggers another Riddler dialogue that you're not able to skip. And that Riddler dialogue overrides this this other Riddler dialogue here that we're going to then skip right now. And so basically you lose a lot of time if you scan Catwoman's collar as the 24th riddle. Because you're not able to skip this Riddler dialogue. So if you end up finding that you have 23 riddles going into this Riddler fight, do not scan Catwoman's collar. Or if you're like rerouting, just keep that in mind. If you ever want to have 23 riddles going into this fight, don't scan Catwoman's collar in that case. And then we'll see we'll see the dialogue coming up. So the next trophy is to grapple to the top of the orphanage and get this thing here. And yeah, you can see, and that, you can hear Riddler's dialogue. Yeah, this Riddler dialogue. It's hard to hear because Joker's also talking, but there's a Riddler dialogue, and that Riddler dialogue really can mess up the... It will prevent you from skipping Riddler dialogues, so you need to be very mindful of that. There's a trophy right there, Crystal Station. Then I like to get this elevator trophy now. It's just a little... This trophy's weird. It's the only way to get it is from this side of the elevator, and there isn't really another point where you'll ever be on this side of the elevator. So then we'll go to the Botanical Gardens. So there's a trophy right here. There's a trophy basically on the lower, the upper part, so we'll head to the upper part now. The easiest way is to go up here. Glide into here, and then you can backlot from pretty far away. Subway car. This, and then you can scan this Hell's Gate riddle right now, which I do. There's an option to not scan it, but I don't. I prefer scanning it, it's just a little more safe. Then you grapple to the top of the car, scan this Vicky Vale thing. And then there's another wooden wall here that you can break into. And again, if you miss the wooden wall, do the thing where you alt-fire the gel onto it and it'll break. And that's also very useful for this next one. There's another wooden wall thing that we're going to get right here. And then again, alt fire. Just drop down an alt fire if you miss it. Then we have this firefighter here, which we will do. Okay, and so here. So there's another Riddler bomb, so we're gonna again cancel this firefighter. Zoom in for safety. Grapple here, cancel the grapple here, and then go on to this. And you can see Batman's eyes are looking towards that TV screen, which is kind of funny. And then you can look for this guy quickly. This Riddler bomb is incredibly awful. It's very hard to find him sometimes. The Riddler bombs are RNG. And sometimes you can just never find them and it's horrible. So yeah, oftentimes you were lucky he's very close, but if he's far, then just use the RC Batarang to go into here and then hit him. Using the Batmobile is not an option. Grapple away before Batman turns towards Riddler again. Then he can just glide. And then here, we will get into our Batmobile. So one thing is that sometimes, like, you might drive your Batmobile off of the bridge by accident. So try not to, because if you don't, then you'll be able to just get into it right here. You don't need to select this objective in this category. You can just go into here. And while we're doing this, we'll also get two upgrades. So one upgrade I already have, which is the turret shot. I have it because of the booster pack. The other one we get is the Vulcan Stabilizer. It's just one upgrade point, and it's very helpful to have in general. If you have the booster pack, you'll have enough upgrade points. You should get reload speed. It's worth getting. I'm not going to get it just to make it, because like some people might not have the booster pack. So I'll just kind of go through the upgrades in the order they are on the tracker. But if you have the booster pack, definitely get reload speed. It is extremely worth it. So when we get to this objective, shoot the shield here on GCPD and shoot the shield here on the cord building, and then eject from the Batmobile. So when Alfred says business, there's like a dialogue queue I have where basically militia presence ahead. That's when I eject from the Batmobile. And then you can grapple here. And then this is similar to Glitchless. You want to make sure you don't grapple too far away from the bridge before, otherwise the bridge won't raise. So I basically have this gliding route where I grapple over here. And then this is like slow enough so that we're close enough to the bridge to lower it. So now, as we go to to the Oracle Crash, you can scan the hospital. I haven't gotten good at this, but ideally what you want to do is scan this while gliding. So let's see if I can do it. Something like that. Yeah. So that's the hospital riddle. It's the fastest way of doing it, I think. So here, sometimes it doesn't work when you like just walk up to it, so just dive backwards and dive forwards and then it will work. The Arkham Knight must have taken Oracle and moved on. I should examine the vehicle more closely. So here, this is standard. Yeah, there's nothing really, there's nothing too much here to go over. This is same as Glitchless. The door was torn off during the crash. If I can find where it came to rest, I can determine exactly what happened. Well, especially for these first few. The next few, there's a little bit more to it. Like for example, I guess here, You can scan this from standing here. You don't have to get that close to it. So it's just practicing getting familiar with where you need to stand. Here, yeah, I stand about here, and then move the camera forward a bit and then interact. Oracle got free of the vehicle before the crash. Yeah, sorry, I'm not going to be interacting with chat too much because this is a tutorial video I'm putting on YouTube. So this next, the bullet hole on the ground, we will move forward a little bit, just a hair, and then you can scan this.
Thank you.
And you can start holding the rewind button really early.
I've missed something. Oracle knew she couldn't escape, but she caused this crash for a reason. She must have left a clue while crawling away.
And one thing on 30 FPS, skipping dialogue too early is a thing, where basically the video and audio are kind of separate, and it's possible to skip the video but not the audio. It's very annoying when that happens. So sometimes you want to like skip the dialogue a little more slowly than you would think. So get in the car. There's a shield right here, so I like to shoot that. And then we'll do Firefly. So the first Firefly is right by this fire station right here. Sometimes there are tanks here. You gotta just, if they see you, you shoot them. Then do Firefly. So the thing about Firefly is that the starting locations are fixed for these fire stations, but the path Firefly takes and his ending location is gonna be completely random. It's very annoying. Firefly, this Firefly thing is not too bad. There aren't really a lot of too many slow paths he can, or like difficult to follow paths he can take. Like, this is okay. I guess the most annoying one is if, like, when he goes like around here, because then he can go up these, he can go sometimes go up the stairs, which is like really hard for the Batmobile to navigate through too. Okay. And the main thing is you want to be a certain distance. You can't get too far away from Firefly, otherwise his fuel doesn't run out. So that's so if you're too far from him like a little bit, then basically this gets slower. The other thing is I find drifting to not be super useful in Firefly. I find getting into tank mode to like slow down and like turn is a little bit better. Drifting is a little weird, I think. It doesn't quite work in Firefly, I don't think. So, because Firefly's ending position is random, there's a case to be made for routing in Azrael, who is right here, if you end up in a really bad spot. I don't really do that because I like keeping my splits consistent and the route consistent, but in general, like if you want to be optimal, you do want to do that. You should do Azrael right now if you're close to him. Sometimes you're not. A lot of times you're not close to him. In fact, oftentimes you're not close to him. But I'm not going to do that right now, just because I want to kind of show what the current route is. So like now what you're supposed to do is the next thing on the route is, so you see that there's this intersection here. There's a building near it, right between the intersection and Grand Avenue Station, which is right here. So it's this building up here. There's a trophy up here. So that's the next trophy that we get. And then there's a trophy in Grand Avenue that we'll get. And then you can grapple cancel off of this gargoyle here. And then you'll have enough speed to go over to the Wayne Tower stairs, which are right here. I find it easier to just walk up to the trophy and press space rather than backclawing it. That's me personally. Sometimes here you have to select the objective. So I think I do now. Sometimes you don't. I don't really understand why. So open this door.
Nice of you to drop in, Mr.
And then here we will get to select our first Batmobile upgrade. So the one I do the same one as in Glitchless, which is the weapons generator Mark 3. Because we don't need the drone virus yet, so this one's a little more useful. And hold aim, scan this. And then I like to fall here for a bit. This glide can sometimes not work, but this is like what's intended. So we glide into this building right here. I like to sometimes, if I can, I like to glide to about here and then backclaw this. When you're running out, throw a batarang at this window here, and then you can then call your Batmobile when you there. Try to not get spotted by tanks, and then shoot this Gotham Globe shield. And then there's this shield right behind this trophy that we're gonna do here. So we got spotted. Sometimes it's unavoidable. I did nothing that would get me like I was just minding my own business, but sometimes it happens. The game just can throw these kinds of things at you. So you got this trophy here, and then you have to shoot this this thing to get out. And then yeah, then we do this tank fight. Try to only shoot the tanks that are like in this area, so that you don't aggro too many of them. Otherwise, the tank fight just takes longer. So I aggroed like six more extra tanks than I needed to, I think. Yeah, but this is all standard now. So pull down this fan. This is all standard. If you've done Glitchless, this is not really different. So if I was closer to this, what you can do is you can dive through this, and then it also breaks this door. I messed it up there, but yeah. So then get your RC Batarang out. Throw it here. So I like to throw the RC Batarang again from out here. That way, when I go use my line launcher again, the door will be open by the time I'm using it, because it takes a little bit of time. Whereas if I was closer, then I'd have to wait for the door to open. Here, you can't use gadgets. You can't use gadgets, so you have to like run up and like press space. I like to crouch. It's just a little bit easier. Running can, like, if you press space while doing it, like, you can dive roll by accident, or like Batman will stop running. It's kind of annoying. Go here, go here, here.
Not your best day at the office, Bat. Something on your mind?
So in this fight, For the first two waves of people or militia people, you have a one-hit KO, so make use of uneasy. So make use of that. Makes it the fight a bit faster if you use that. So here, we will so counter this guy, then do the standard glitchless thing, which is to backclaw him to this light. Yeah, but this last phase does not have one hit KO. So, you have to kind of take them out normally. Ideally with, like, multi-grounds. Do not cancel this. Things get really weird when you cancel this. So I highly recommend not canceling it. But yeah, you could do a door cancel on these switches and... Sorry. You can do a door cancel on these switches in general, but this one in particular you don't want to. This tank fight gets kind of weird when you do. Okay, so this Miyagani Tunnel, so we're going to do this card shape. This APC... This APC is same as glitchless, except I'm much worse at it for some reason in this category. But basically you can take out. So when you interact with this, you can get in the Batmobile right now, and then you can take out the last support vehicle really quickly, like that, and then it's no longer going to be part of the chase and. And there's no slowdown animation, so it's much faster. And then the other thing is, you do want to take out the support vehicles for this APC chase because the APC takes a lot more damage when there are no support vehicles, for whatever reason. So if you destroy this APC really quickly, like I did, a lot of times it doesn't work. Then there's a very good case for scanning the Hell's Gate riddle right now. Usually you're not going to be by here, so I that's why it's safer to scan it earlier. What I did. Oh yeah, do not cancel the animation to interrogate this guy. You won't be able to run over the guy's head if you do that.
Where is he?
With Barbara Gordon. She's ours now. Can you imagine what the knight's going to do to her?
What are you doing?
No, you can't do this.
So you don't need to run over his head for very long for either of these two parts. Yeah, sometimes you get unlucky and get this really long dialogue. There's I mean, it's just random, so. Most of the dialogues are much faster. That one just happens to be incredibly slow. It's like 10 seconds.
Thank you.
So now we'll get our Batmobile upgrade. So after this Batmobile upgrade, we're supposed to do a tank fight, but we can skip that. The way we skip that is we just eject from our Batmobile immediately, and then glide away. What we're going to do is we're going to glide on to the church here because there is a trophy. Then go down here and get into your Batmobile. Then I like to, you want to go towards Mercy Bridge. So Mercy Bridge, so there's a shield right here. And then there's a firefighter right here, so we can just shoot these guys. It's a little faster than fighting them. And then what we'll do is we'll cancel this firefighter. And zoom in. And then grapple and get into your Batmobile up here. And then you're in your Batmobile. Then what we do next is we select this APC. If you're on Miyagani Island and you select this APC is going to be on Leak. So we kind of just select the APC. And so APC spawns are basically random and their path is random. Everything about them is random. Even sometimes the island that they spawn on it when you select the mission is random. But the only constant is that there are three on each island. And also sometimes, like, if you're on a certain island, you can manipulate where they spawn. So we did that there because I think this first APC, I think, is always on Bleak. I don't know of a time when it's not. I've never had a case where it's not on Bleak, especially if you select it from Miyagani. Here we happen to get an APC that's fairly close. Sometimes it can be on the opposite side of Miyagani. These APCs are like one of the most annoying parts of running this category. There's just a lot of randomness for it. So if it's like 400 meters away or like around this area. Oh, wait. Okay. That was weird. Okay. But it happened to be fine. So here we don't destroy the support vehicles. Because the thing is, like, the dynamics of these APC chases are a bit different. So because of that, the APCs take less damage when you shoot them with the immobilizer. So you want to actually sideswipe them a lot. Sideswiping is the best way of doing a lot of damage to them. But yeah, the reason why we don't destroy the support vehicles is because in the first APC chase, the story APC chase, we start behind the militia vehicles, which makes it easy for us to destroy them. But here, the support vehicles will spawn behind us. So again, like, the dynamics are different, and especially in later APCs, there are like six support vehicles. It's way too slow it's better to just try to sideswipe the APCs. We'll go to the next objective, which is, to start tracking this penguin truck. Or to at least talk with rendezvous with Nightwing and get our Disruptor. The main reason to do this is to get our Disruptor. This is required for a lot of trophies. I can disable enemy weapons. And we have to do this tutorial. So a tutorial, just shoot a guy's gun once and shoot the other guy's gun twice. That's the fastest way. And then we're going to not actually track the penguin truck. We're going to skip tracking the penguin truck. Before we do that. First, we'll do Azrael. So if you haven't done Azrael yet, just do, this is where you generally will have him routed.
As you wish.
Yeah, so you want to do this fight without getting hit. It's, this fight's pretty straightforward. Just, you know, make sure you use your multi-ground. But this fight's easy, and we're playing on easy, so it's not really a big deal. And so next we're going to actually do the Penguin Skip. Now, if you, I don't know, you may not have seen my video on Penguin Skip. I have like a, basically the, whether or not this crashes without Season of Infamy Assault depends on where you reloaded from checkpoint. So what you do is if you get in the corner cover here, if you reloaded from checkpoint in the overworld, then doing Penguin Skip from this corner works. But we reloaded last in the clock tower. And if you're doing the route on PC, you will have reloaded in the clock tower, most likely. If you've reloaded in the clock tower, you actually want to then get over to this corner and then do Penguin Skip. Otherwise, if you do it from the other corner, it'll crash. Yeah, so this door is closed. So the big problem with this door being closed is that when we try to come out, we can't actually get out. In any percent, you would do some skips to... You would do like a door cancel to do it, but what we'll do instead is if we go into here, you get an autosave, then reload from checkpoint. And then the door should be open when we leave. Hopefully that's actually the case. I've never actually tested that reload, but I think that reload is correct, but we'll see. We'll find out together. Barbara Gordon, tell me where they are. This fight, you have multi-ground, so this fight can be really fast. Much faster than in any percent. In your body, Cobblepot. They were going to see some geezer called Simon Stagg. A fakey runs a pharmaceutical company or something.
Do not lie to me.
Scarecrow's gonna break you. You are going down, Batman.
Hold him steady, fellas. I've been working on my swing. Watch and learn. Gonna knock his head right out of the...
This is you handling it, right? Don't worry. You can thank me later.
Kill him. Okay, so... Yeah, here, just make use of your multi-ground. And again, the pattern of punch, batarang. For this guy here, it's using the stick is a good way of taking him out. You don't use a combo. If using a combo takedown gets rid of your combo, so then here. You can cancel this door like we do in any percent. It depends completely on where you stand. So stand, basically the visual cue is be halfway between this rug and not the rug, and stand like in front of this door. And then it'll usually work. Oops. There we go. Then... exit. So we'll see if that reload worked. If the reload doesn't work, then you reload now. Oh, doesn't work. Okay. All right. So then reload. Then you reload. Reload after you blow up the cache, I guess. And then yeah. Sorry about that. So reload after you blow up the cache, and then now when we come out here, the door will be open. Find out everything you can And the reason why we do this is because we need to use our Batmobile to get some shields and trophies. So it is better. Like, you could route in that any percent skip to get out of here, but I don't think it's worth it. In general, like, you need your Batmobile on the top of the parking garage anyway. I think it's not worth it to do this. Anyway, so what we'll do is we will go up the parking garage. On the way, we will actually shoot two shields. So the first shield is right up here. And the next shield is right here. Then we will shoot these guys. Destroy that. And then before we go back to Batman, drive the Batmobile over to here. Prepare to solve this trophy. And then go down here. And then shoot this breakable wall for this next trophy. And then now as Batman will collect those two trophies. You can't really see Batman. I'm just gliding in a direction closer to where like I want to go. It's not really a scientific, but yeah. So we grab that trophy. That's the garage jump. And then we grab this trophy, which is Gotham Casino. Then get in the Batmobile, and then we will do our second APC. This APC is always on Miyagani, and it's always like pretty close, so it tends to be very convenient. I like doing this APC now. Sometimes that you want, so now the next objective we have is to go to Bleak. Sometimes the APC will go to Bleak. Usually it will go into the worst possible place. And so yeah, in general, the way that we try to route these APCs is when we have to change islands, it's usually a good idea to try to route an APC into that. Like, if we have to go a far distance, I usually try to route an APC into that. That's usually how we try to route these APCs in. It is possible to not route the APCs in at all and to just do them when you see them. I don't like that approach because a lot of the time, like, the route is very fine-tuned so that like your groups of trophies are like very clustered together, and doing an APC in the middle of that can interfere with that. I don't know, it's probably a preference thing. And the other thing is having these routed in specifically, it's nice because it keeps your splits consistent. But that's a preference thing. I have the APCs routed completely, but you don't have to. So now we'll go to the next Firefly, which is right by GCPD. This Firefly can be annoying. If he goes into a tunnel, that's like the worst possible thing he can do. It gets so much slower when he goes into a tunnel, so you kind of just hope that doesn't happen. You don't really have much control over it. And sometimes he can take like some very sharp turns, which it's not really fun, but yeah. And if you're very lucky, Firefly will end up close to your next objective. Usually he'll end up as far away as possible from your next objective. At least that's what it feels like. Yes, this is like some these turns are a little difficult to follow. Sometimes they'll like spin around in like a circle for a bit and then like go into a direction. Be very mindful of that. Like, Also, look at the text. There's like, so I have hints turned on. If you have hints turned on, it tells you when you're able to take him down. So sometimes it'll say take down, but it says get in range, so you can't take him down when it says that. So you need to basically wait until it says it doesn't say get in range, then you're actually in range, and then it'll work. So when you're doing Firefly, just make sure that he's in range before you try to take him down. Okay, so the next thing we'll do is the Riddler puzzle on Bleak. This is by Ace Chemicals, so we will basically head over to around there. So it's right here. Sometimes Firefly will end up here, usually he won't. And so here we will skip this dialogue. We will also get some upgrades. I like to get the Grapnel Boost Mark III, and I like to get Grapple Takedown. I just really like getting Grapnel Boosts. It makes your movement a lot. It's just easier to move. It's easier to glide. Sometimes you don't have very good cancel spots that are easy. Having this makes it a little bit more consistent. So this puzzle is not really a big deal, but there's a strat you can do that I've never gotten to work consistently, but some people have. I'll just kind of showcase what it is. Basically, if you go right here and then have your Batmobile a little bit off, and then you basically, you can have this thing shoot your Batmobile over to the other side of the map. It's not really working. I'm not good at it. Something like this. So that worked, so that's a strat you can do. I don't ever do that, maybe I'll start doing that. That's kind of the strat you can do. I don't really know how it works. So cancel this dialogue, and then get on this, and then cancel this dialogue. And then you can switch to Catwoman. So the correct key, so the way on the tracker, you notice it says 03. So what that means is that index. So this is, this point is 00. Then this is 10. This is 1, 2, 3, 4. And then also it's 0, 1, 2, 3, 4. So the first one is basically the X coordinate, and the other one is the Y coordinate. So this is if you were looking at a bird's eye view, that's what it would be. So 03, what that is, this is basically column 0 and row 3. So 0, 1, 2, 3. So it's this key here, and that's basically what that hint means. You'll get used to it, but if you're starting out, that's what it means. One down. Riddler's gonna speak, so cancel his dialogue. And then he'll speak again, so cancel his dialogue again. And then again, in this elevator, we will cancel his dialogue again. Whoops. So next we have this firefighter at this lighthouse in Founders Island. This firefighter is interesting. So one thing, if you know the trophies in this game, there's a trophy on the lighthouse. We're gonna actually not get that. We'll get that later. It might seem weird now, but it'll kind of make sense later on. But we will get two other trophies. Basically, while we cancel a firefighter. So what we'll first do is we will go up to the lighthouse, not get the trophy, but we will take out this sniper. So there's a trophy like behind the sniper. Then what we'll do is we'll go over here, take out this jammer guy. And then what we'll do is do that thing where we break that door, that breakable wall. Then we will take these guys out. So in these predators on easy, you can kind of just punch people. I'm gonna just make sure that I did break the wall. Yeah, I did. So now what we'll do is now what we'll do is we zoom in and cancel this firefighter, and then we're going to get two trophies while we cancel him. So we set up this one to get. Oops. And then this is very tight. This isn't going to work. Or maybe it will. There we go. So it's a little tight, but you can get it. And then we'll do this watchtower. This is the kind of the story watchtower. Before we do stag, so cancel this guy. Make sure you're in detective vision again, similar to any percent. The only difference is that this guy is a little bit farther forward than he would be in any percent. And then, yeah, then if these guys climb down the ladder, throw smoke, and then fear takedown. Whoops. And then, yeah, then now to disable the tower. Destroy this. So here, what you can do is, so in any percent, you would zoom in and grapple that, and then cancel. Oh, whoops, not that. You'd zoom in here, and because we have the grapple boost, we can just boost off of this. It makes it much easier, and we actually have enough speed to then just grapple directly to the top. So that's the main reason to get grapple boost this early. So we get this, and then we'll go into stag, and I'm going to actually end this part of the tutorial after we get into stag, because this tutorial is going to be multiple parts. This is going to be the end of the first part. We'll do the second part at a later date. And yeah, so yeah, thanks everyone for watching this, and we will continue on with this 100% tutorial from stag. After at a future point. So thanks for watching.